Hi, how are you? I'm just passing on your qualifying goals for this weekend.
Good afternoon, and we hope you're ready for an exciting qualifying session as the teams make their final preparations here in Canada. When it comes to getting lap time out of this circuit, it's traditionally been about maximizing top speed. Do you simply remove as much downforce as possible, hang on in the corners and max out down the straights?
Top speed is a key factor for this circuit. Even if you can achieve the same lap time as someone running less wing than you, chances are you'll find overtaking difficult if you have too much drag.
As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Rosberg, Hamilton and Daniel Kvyat. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then.
Hi, guess who? I've seen the team's expectations for the race, so I thought I'd pass them on and wish you luck. Take care.
There is, as I look out of my commentary box window, a very large and very excited crowd here today, eagerly anticipating another memorable race. Lewis Hamilton took his maiden win on this circuit in 2007. Jenson Button came from last place to win here in 2011. And there's certainly no shortage of drama on offer here at the Canadian Grand Prix. If you want flat-out racing, you've come to the right place this weekend, as it's full throttle for 59% of this 2.7-mile circuit, peaking at around 210 miles per hour going into the final chicane. But that speed requires discipline, and there are more than a few close walls here just waiting to punish drivers with a heavy right foot. Joining me to talk you through the action today is Anthony Davidson. And give us an idea of what kind of thing you're going to be looking out for today.
Well, the big question for me is whether or not we're going to see the cars able to follow each other closely enough to overtake, especially through the fast sections here. Of course, we've got DRS and that will help on the straights, but it's still no good if you're coming off the previous corner too slowly or too far behind.
Keep your eyes open on the run to turn one and keep it clean. We want to come out in one piece. Good luck.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Nico Rosberg will start his Silver Arrow from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Kvyat, Gutierrez, Max Verstappen, and Ricciardo, Grosjean, Perez, Bottas, and Kevin Magnussen, Hülkenberg, Alonso, Felipe Massa, and Raikkonen, Vettel, Button, Julian Palmer, and Marcus Ericsson, Harry Anto, and Wehrlein, Felipe Nasser, and a Toro Rosso rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track. win then for the Force India team today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Well, the safety car completely changed the race, didn't it? It's hard to say exactly what would have happened without it, but there's no question that they came out of that situation in a good position.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Well, the lead at the top has come down after a poor result for our points leader. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I think I'll have to give it to the Toro Rosso driver. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Red Bull moved to the top of the table. Meanwhile, Toro Rosso's strong weekend allows them to continue their march up the table. It was great having you with us for this weekend. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Until next time though, goodbye.